U.S. support for Ukraine in their war against the brutal attack by Russia. It's good to be back in Kyiv. I was telling the president, one of my number of staff members on the flight from Washington into Poland asked me how many times I've been to Kyiv. And I had to stop and think. It's my 8th trip. And much has changed. Much of it bad with the invasion, but also the Ukrainian people have stepped up in a way that few people ever have in their defense, and have apparently also embraced the notions of democracy. No longer discussions about whether or not certain privileged people have control. And, and I bring greetings and goodwill from the members of Congress, and you made a very good impression, as you know, when you spoke there last. And for all the disagreement we have in our Congress on some issues, there is significant agreement on support for Ukraine. Because this is so much larger than just Ukraine. It's about freedom and democracy in Europe. It's about freedom and democracy writ large. All the American people, I know that so many have been kept the Ukrainian people, particularly the women and children, in their prayers, seeing what's happened. They can't fathom the idea of the shelling at night and the shelling of everything, orphanages to schools, to the like. It's barbaric. And I'm here to show our unwavering support for the nation's independence, their sovereignty, and territorial integrity. And today, I hope we're going to have a chance to discuss how the United States and our allies, by keeping constant contact with and our partners, can most effectively support you and your cause, Mr. President. And I look forward to discussing all of this and then addressing the world with you afterwards.